Good day and welcome back. We'll continue with the chapter 19 system in simple harmonic motions. We have learned a lot about the simple harmonic motions that we learned about the displacement, velocity, accelerations, and the energy in the systems. And now we're going to learn how to derive the periods of the oscillations, especially for the spring mass and the simple pendulum systems. Let's start with our old friend, simple pendulum system. We have the rod attached to a string with the length L. So the rod has a mass, so there's a weight acted on the rod itself. Here, the weight, of course, is in downward directions, and we resolve the weight into two components. One is along the string, and another one is perpendicular to the string. So for the components of mg cos theta, it is actually balanced by the tension in the string. So the net force acted on the rod is the mg sin theta, which produces the simple harmonic motions. If we consider the direction to the right as the positive directions, we have the net force is equal to mg sin theta, and we can apply the small angle approximations that sin theta is approximate to the theta in radian form if the angle is very small. So here we can apply the formula from the circular measure that the arc length s is equal to r theta. Based on the diagram, we can see that the displacement, which is also the arc length, is equal to the product of the length and the angle displaced. So substitute the equations and you can obtain that the force is equal to negative mg multiplied x over L. And based on the definition of simple harmonic motions that we have, the force is equal to negative m omega squared x. So compare these two equations, we can obtain the equations of omega squared is equal to g over L. And don't forget that angular frequency is equal to 2 pi over t. So rearrange the formula and we can obtain the expression of the period is equal to 2 pi multiplied the square of L over g. So from what I have read, so the equations here is only valid when the angle or the amplitude is very small and it is suggested to be less than 15 degrees. So after we have derived the formula of the period, let's try one question from the trial of SMK Yu Hua in 2021. The figure here shows the system of simple pendulum with the length of the string is 1 meter and it is released at an angle of 8 degrees to the vertical.
The magnitude of the angle displaced at the very beginning actually determines the amplitude of the simple harmonic motion.
Based on the previous discussion, we can obtain the amplitude simply by applying the formula of S is equal to R theta. So here you just get the length of the string, which is 1 meter, multiply the angle in radian form. And you will obtain the amplitude is equal to 0.139 meter. You also can try yourself to apply the formula of L sin theta, and you will get the answer is almost the same. And then we also can apply the formula that we have derived to obtain the period of the motions, which is equal to 2.01 second. And remember that the frequency is equal to the reciprocal of the period, and you can obtain it is equal to 0.498 hertz. And you also can obtain the angular frequency, which is equal to 2 pi f, and you will get 3.13 radian per second. So we have explored almost all the variables in the simple harmonic motions. With these informations, you can continue to solve questions that relate to the displacement, velocity, accelerations, or the energy in the systems. Next, we're going to look at another system, which is the spring mass system. Let's consider the test of the horizontal spring first. The spring here was not stretched or pulled initially. To produce the simple harmonic motions, we're going to pull the rod to a certain distance and the spring is extended at the length of x. So there will be a tension in the spring which is given as the formula of kx. When we release the rod, due to the tension in the spring, the rod will continue to oscillate to the left and right periodically. So we'll take the direction to the right as the positive directions, and from the formula of F is equal to ma, the net force acted on the rod will be the force in the spring which is equal to negative kx. Rearrange the formula and you can obtain the expression is equal to negative k over m multiplied x. So once again, based on the definition of simple harmonic motions, that expression is equal to negative omega squared x. Compare these two equations and you can obtain the expression of omega squared is equal to k over m. Again, put in the formula of angular frequency and rearrange the formula, you can obtain the period is equal to 2 pi multiplied the square of m over k. So there are two very important assumptions here that the formula is valid. First is the smooth surface that there is no friction between the rod and the surface. And second is the spring obeys the Hooke's law. Next, we are going to look at the vertical spring mass systems. For this time, when you hang the log on the spring, the weight of the log will cause the spring to extend. Before we produce the simple harmonic motions, here we have the tension of the spring is equal to the weight of the log. So we have the equations of the Ke is equal to mg. And then we're going to pull down the log and cause the spring to extend again, which labeled as the length x. So the total extension of the spring here will be equal to E plus x, which is then multiply the K and give us the tension in the spring. So when we release the log, the tension in the spring will cause the log to oscillate up and down periodically. So we're going to repeat almost the same step, and we will take the downward directions as the positive directions. Based on the formula F is equal to ma, we will have the net force is equal to the weight minus the tension, and it is equal to ma. Put in the formula of the weight and the tension, and also substitute the formula of mg is equal to ke, and you will obtain negative kx is equal to ma. Rearrange the formula, and you can obtain the assertion is equal to negative k over m multiplied x. So again, compared with the definition of simple harmonic motions, you can obtain the omega squared is equal to k over m, and put in the formula of angular frequency, you can obtain the period is equal to 2 pi multiplied square of m over k. In this system, you also can get another formula for the period where you can replace the m over k as e over g. There's one thing that you need to take note here. Based on the second equation here, it seems like the period is depending on the value of the extension and the gravitational accelerations. But I want you to recall back the situation when the spring mass system is in a stationary condition. We have the equations of Ke is equal to mg, and we can see that the extension is proportional to the value of g. So from here, we can deduce that the E over g is a constant value. Hence, the period of the simple harmonic motion in a spring mass system is actually not affected by the value of g. In another word, if you put the spring mass system on the moon, we still can get the same value for the period of the oscillations. So in short, the simple harmonic motion in the spring mass system is due to the spring itself. So the period is depending on the mass and the spring constant. And compared to the simple harmonic motion in simple pendulum system, we can see that the net force in the system is due to the gravity. So the period of the oscillation is depending on the length of the spring and the gravitational accelerations, which is different with the spring mass system. So that's conclude my discussion about chapter 19. If you still have any questions, you can leave it in the comment section below. Also, do leave a like and subscribe my channel. I will see you in my next video. Thank you.